Welcome to Introduce the Cosine Trig Ratio, slide 1. In this example, we have a right angle triangle with an angle x, a side length 5, and another side length of 13. We are dealing with trigonometrics because we have a right angle triangle. So now we have to identify the angle and label the sides before we can choose the trig ratio. So let's look at this and see what's our referent angle. And it happens to be angle x. Next, if we look at the perspective of angle x, we are given an adjacent side that touches the x and the 90. So we are given adjacent. And likewise, if we go directly across from the 90 degrees, we have the hypotenuse. And the hypotenuse is 13. So given the angle, the adjacent, and hypotenuse figures, we choose the trig ratio as ka, or cosine of an angle is equal to the adjacent divided by the hypotenuse, as the following formula suggests. Next, what we're going to do is to substitute the values into the desired ratio. So we know adjacent is 5, hypotenuse is 13. Let's substitute. And you should get the cosine of x is equal to 5 divided by 13. So that's the key critical start right there. We are going to convert to a decimal. So let's do that. We're going to convert that to the cosine of x is equal to decimal 3846. Now the next step is to take the cos inverse of both the left and right sides. So if you take the cos inverse of cos x, you will get angle x, but the right side will yield the following. You'll have the cos inverse of decimal 3846. Now, depending on how your calculator operates, you may have to go shift or second function, then cosine, and then enter the four digits, or you may have to enter the four digits, press cos inverse by hitting shift, hitting cos, hitting equals, and you should get the following result. X is 67.4 degrees.